Hello, everybody. My name is Regina. I use she, her pronouns, and I am incredibly excited to be welcoming you to this 2023 Femme Fatale Film Festival. Thank you for joining us virtually, and let's watch these international films. Before we start, and before we introduce you to the screenings, I would like to acknowledge that we're hosting our in-person event on the traditional lands of Mississauga, of the Credit, the Anishinaabeg, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat people. More than just a land acknowledgement, we invite you to reflect on it personally and as part of a community of what it really means to you and as a person living in so-called Canada. I am going to speak for a few minutes about how this started, who we are, why we do it, how we do it a little bit, and why we do it. Also, I will provide at the end a little bit of information that it's really, really important for you to know before we watch these amazing international films. Okay, so Femme Fatale started out of the desires cave of hyper-masculinity in the film industry. Our founder, Astrid Moore, wanted to create a space for their community of female and gender-diverse filmmakers to gather and celebrate each and one another's accomplishments. The festival was originally part of a school project that Astrid only planned to run for about a year, and it was 2018. The audience and community response to the festival kept the festival going, honestly. Now, 6 years from 6 years later from that 2018 festival, Femme Fatale is an annual festival, a podcast, and most importantly, a community. So I will start telling a little bit about myself. My name is Regina, as I said before. I am Mexican, but currently I am studying in Toronto film and TV production. I found Femme Fatale on Instagram and I instantly fell in love with the project. So truth is, I started spamming our founder Astrid and begging her to be part of this wonderful project. I really liked it because this community empowers women and gender diverse filmmakers. And that's something really important to me because in most of the film productions I have worked with, I usually feel a little, well, not a little, a lot of inequality and discrimination for being a woman in film. And Femme Fatale is a platform I found really strong to be close to my passion and empower myself as a filmmaker, but also helping grow people and filmmakers, female and gender diverse, to never feel silenced or discriminated as voices or filmmakers or storytellers or artists. So let's keep going. Femme Fatale is a registered non-for-profit. We rely on grants, sponsorships, and donations to operate. So this year, we're incredibly grateful to have received the Building Community Through Arts and Heritage Program grant from the Government of Canada Heritage Department. We would also like to extend our huge thanks to Hunter Liberatory Law, who has generally sponsored this event for the second year in a row. Last but not least, I would like to extend a massive thank you to everyone who has bought a ticket, merchandise, or donated to the event. Every little bit counts. And so we, as the Femme Fatale team, are really, really, really thankful. Also, I like to thank my team. Thank you, Astrid Moore, Rianne Sproka, Naya Hofer, Amelia Watt, for organizing this event. Thank you so, so, so much. This is the most important thing. Thank you so much to our filmmakers for submitting their work, providing press kits, and offering their support. You're incredibly talented, and we are really, really excited to celebrate you tonight. Thank you, everyone who is helping volunteering our in-person event and that we are about to host this weekend as well. So thank you so much. Oh, and don't forget that we run an Audience Choice Award every year, which the winner gets an episode in the podcast, the Femme Fatale podcast. Do not forget to vote on which is your favorite film at the end of the screening. And the link to vote is in the video description and also in the pinned comment. You can listen to past episodes on the Femme Fatale podcast on Spotify, Apple Music, or wherever you get your podcast from. Okay, and the important information you need to know about these films is that they are made by young female or gender diverse filmmakers between the ages of 15 and 25. These films tell stories from all over the world in different languages, various topics, various voices, and we are so honored to be sharing them with you tonight. So without further ado, here are the films.
acha que isso faz mal ao fígado? Pela quantidade de vezes que eu já te vi cá beber isso.
Eu antes vinha aqui muitas vezes, mas sinto cada vez mais tenho motivos para voltar.
Se voltares sempre para o mesmo sítio, não deixas que existam coincidências.
Eu não sou muito fã de coincidências. Prefiro ser eu a decidir o meu próprio destino, sabes?
Isso quer dizer que sempre vieste cá com segundas intenções?
Olha, eu não sei se hoje é um bom dia ou não para te explicar os meus motivos.
Será que é por termos coisas em comum?
Como podes reparar, sim. Temos várias coisas em comum.
Isso é bom. Para despertar o interesse um no outro.
É a melhor maneira de dar o primeiro passo.
Sim, depois temos logo muito mais coisas para falar.
Ou pelo menos alguém se esforça para que isso aconteça.
Mas mesmo assim não quer dizer que sejamos duas pessoas perfeitas uma para a outra.
É, mesmo assim temos de conhecer a pessoa para além dessa primeira camada.
Precisamos conhecer bem a personalidade de ambas.
Duas pessoas que gostam de pintar. Não fazem necessariamente um par perfeito. Há vilões que gostam de arte, não é?
Sim. Pressionam-nos constantemente para estarmos numa relação com alguém, como se não soubéssemos estar sozinhos.
É, dizem, tu e esta pessoa vão estar mesmo bem, ou vocês são iguaizinhos.
Eu sou a minha própria pessoa. Tenho os meus próprios sonhos, objetivos. Posso nem sequer ter tempo para me meter numa relação.
Não podemos ter um tempo só para nós e sermos felizes na mesma.
Embora às vezes também falte sempre aquele afeto e confiança.
É. Temos mesmo de partilhar a felicidade, não é? É bom ter alguém. Mas só quando sentimos que há altura e a pessoa certa.
Forçar relações é sempre uma grande receita para o desastre. Só quando seguimos o nosso coração e sentimos que é a pessoa certa, aí sim é que as coisas podem correr bem.
Bem, o que eu queria dizer era...
Quer sair comigo? Vai que eu trato disto.
My name is Rachel Lutz, and I own the Peacock Room, Frida and Yama in Detroit. I opened the Peacock Room in December of 2011. It was definitely not something that, you know, seemed like a great idea at the time to some people. They told me that I was opening it on the heels of a recession. It just happened to be the right time for me in my life. So it was 11 years ago. About 5 years ago, we expanded to the Fisher Building, just a mile away. It really was extraordinary, the level of support that I got from the Detroit community to keep on pushing and keep on, you know, this path to opening a business in the neighborhood.
I am Bella Jakovac. I've worked here for 1 year and 6 months. I am a operations specialist, yeah. Our most important values, like, the customer is always number one, so even if I'm working on something, you stop everything you do and you go and help a customer and you make sure that they're comfortable in the store so that, you know, they can have a good time.
My name is Candy Chesney. I am a manager here. I was one of the store managers. I'll be celebrating in May 8 years at the Peacock Room. We're like a little family. We all have great relationships with each other. And we have just an array of different ages, different people, different, just all from all different, you know, we have some students, we have just all sorts of people. And it's a great environment to work in.
Online stores don't truly serve a community. I think that they're like the fast food of shopping. They'll feed you, but they don't nourish you. So we hope to keep serving the community in the ways that we already have and to reach more people so we can kind of, you know, evangelize that, I guess.
Being a vampire in high school, it's hard to say the least. Pros of being a senior vampire? It's dark when I arrive. Number two pencils are pretty much non-existent, so there's no need to worry about, you know. And the student body is the primus feeding ground. Exhausted, lethargic, burnt out. Most vampires avoid high school students in all. Fortunately, I was turned on the cusp of my 18th birthday, so it doesn't bother me much.
What's the thing?
Mango jewel pods.
Oh, we're gonna get you suspended.
I was turned during the height of the vampire revolution, the 80s. Before the 1981 election, vampires of a certain political party turned thousands of teenagers so they couldn't vote, and if they could, it'd go to our political candidates. The Burgess! Nixon still won. I've been a senior ever since. One of the cons of being a senior vampire?
Ah.
Well, at first I would say it's the students.
A pair of tiny hooligans stole my umbrella!
Sucks to suck.
I can fly, and suck I did. Those freshmen were not very fresh. Now that's just unsanitary.
Let's just say they've definitely evolved since the 80s.
See that little one over there? I stepped on him last week. Bloody hell, they used last year's picture.
Hey, asshole! What the fuck? Oh. And then there's Corey.
We are the Bad Vampire Hunting Club.
Yeah! People ask me, why does the Bad Vampire Hunting Club meet 3 days a week? Because it's a sport. Vampire hunting is a sport, Mom.
My theory is Jesse Bellamy is a title that's passed down from year to year, class to class, because I've always, since I've been here, known a senior who was Jesse Bellamy.
The Bad Vampire Club. The Bad Vampire Hunting Club meets on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays in Mr. Burns' classroom.
There are only a few students involved, but you know what? It's grown every year, and I love doing it. I love sponsoring it because it brings a competitive edge to the class.
The poem I'm sharing today is a very personal story about how I created the leg warmer trend in the early 80s.
And how do you do that?
Well, as a cold-blooded creature of the night.
Did y'all hear that?
Not again, Corey.
You're telling me you did not just hear her say she's a creature of the night?
Cold-blooded?
See?
It's also just really entertaining.
She has red eyes!
Just because like, she has an iron deficiency doesn't mean we should bully her!
You ignorant fools! She's gonna eat us all!
Do you wanna hear the poetry or not? What the hell?
I got rid of your pencil. I told you it would work.
Leave me alone!
Corey, you can't kill Jesse Bellamy.
Why not?
Because if you kill her, then who are you gonna kill?
Huh?
You're the Vampire Hunting Club. What are you gonna do tomorrow if you can't hunt her?
We don't meet on Tuesdays.
What about Wednesday? Without her, your club has no meaning. Look, you caught her. You win, all right? What are you gonna do without her?
In all my years of staying here, not one student has actually believed that I'm a vampire. So, whether or not I'm being hunted or actually killed, it's nice to be seen for once.
Thank you. I'm beautiful.
I am beautiful.
I am beautiful.
Beautiful.
Buckle up, Macy X, because you are not going to believe this one. Before we get into it, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications so you never have to wait for a brand new episode. This episode is sponsored by me. Are you trying to get that autumn sparkly golden glow? Use promo code MACYAC in the Macy's shop for 10% off Macy's lip juice. Supplies are limited, so act fast to get juicing. So yeah, back to Macy's Messy Monday. I was already running late, which is typical for me on a Monday morning, especially when I've got my balloon. And I spotted something shiny out of the corner of my eye.
Mondays.
Is it my lucky day? Sure was. But with my hands so full, I just couldn't grab it.
Oh no!
No, 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 no! The struggle was real, Macy X. Even worse.
It's Canadian.
Balloon gone, but coin in hand, I finally bundled into school. And as I bundled, there she was.
Hey, Macy.
Hey, Samantha.
I don't see you on my late list. That means that you're tardy. And you stole my pencil like months ago and still haven't given it back to me.
I've been telling you for 9 months, I don't have your pencil. I've been offering to get you a new pencil.
Hey, babe.
Oh, hey, babe, how are you?
I'm great, how about you?
I'm doing good.
Are you still on for later?
Yeah, of course.
Perfect. I gotta go.
All right, love you.
Love you too.
Me and Freddie, it's magical.
You guys are disgusting.
Samantha went on and on about how they're not disgusting, but anyone who's seen them hold hands knows otherwise. Still, she persisted. And say what you will, but that girl knows her sweat.
He doesn't care about my sweaty hands. We hold hands in the movies like all the time. And when I wipe my hands in my jeans, he doesn't even notice. And besides, I'm getting treatment. Like the doctor said they can do something about it, so I don't even care.
I'm glad you're getting treatment.
Don't forget about my pencil. I want my pencil.
Okay, I get it.
Yeah, so already running late, I had to present my diorama. The ocean is really important to me. Like, save the turtles and all that.
But if the ocean thinks it has it bad...
I'll buy you a whole new pack, Samantha, okay? My diorama. It's ruined.
What happened?
I'm so sorry, I wasn't looking.
One cup away.
I'm so sorry, it was Samantha. I wasn't looking. It's her sweaty hands and I just...
What? Competition's tomorrow. Who do you think put all these trophies in here?
Soccer?
Cups! It's all cups.
I'm sorry,
I have to say I learned a lot about cup stacking. It is a thing and it is very serious. So sorry about that, and good luck to our Cup Squad at State Semis next week. Anyways, I've already had a pretty messy Monday. And what came next?
What a messy Monday. someone playing dodgeball?
Dodgeball to the face?
Oh, God, I guess so. Jeez, is that a full deck of cards?
Where the hell did those even come from?
Oh, guess not. Ah! A stuffed fox?
What's next, a freaking yoga mat? Sure was. So, probably my messiest of Mondays. Until next time, ACX. And remember what I always say. Purpose fuels passion.
My name is Rachel Lutz, and I own the Peacock Room, Frida, and Yama in Detroit. I opened the Peacock Room in December of 2011. It was definitely not something that, you know, seemed like a great idea at the time to some people. They told me that. I was opening it on the heels of a recession. It just happened to be the right time for me in my life. So it was 11 years ago. About 5 years ago, we expanded to the Fisher Building, just a mile away. It really was extraordinary, the level of support that I got from the Detroit community to keep on pushing and keep on, you know, this path to opening a business in the neighborhood.
I am Bella Jakovac. I've worked here for 1 year and 6 months. I am a operations specialist, yeah. Our most important values, like, the customer is always number one, so even if I'm working on something, you stop everything you do and you go and help a customer and you make sure that they're comfortable in the store so that, you know, they can have a good time.
My name is Candy Chesney. I am a manager here, as one of the store managers. I'll be celebrating in May 8 years at the Peacock Room. We're like a little family. We all have great relationships with each other. And we have just an array of different ages, different people, different, just all from all different, you know, we have some students, we have just all sorts of people. And it's a great environment to work in.
Online stores don't truly serve a community. I think that they're like the fast food of shopping. They'll feed you, but they don't nourish you. So we hope to keep serving the community in the ways that we already have and to reach more people so we can kind of, you know, evangelize that, I guess.
Yeah. Costume.
Well, I read that the first step to becoming an adult is to be comfortable with your appearance. And I'm not comfortable with my appearance when I'm wearing a grape costume.
Is that why you're wearing eyeliner?
Yes. I'm trying a new look. Do you like it?
If you like it, then I like it. I can help fix it up, if you like.
I'm good, but thanks.
What? I can fix it to be like a kite eye. It'll be very chic and very ladylike. You'll look like Audrey Hepburn. You will look like a movie star. Oh la la, no?
Mom, we're not doing this right now. You know I don't want your help. I'm good.
Fine. I'm just trying to help. But apparently, you don't need it anymore. Because you want to look like a grown woman who looks like, instead of Audrey Hepburn, or an adorable grape.
Sex work is real work, Mom.
Go. You don't want to keep me waiting.
Why are you still wearing your grape costume? We are running away and not doing the costume contest. Remember?
Yeah, but this costume is really cute, so I still wanted to wear it.
Why is there so much hair in your face?
I can't reach my face.
Oh.
Okay. Right? Because remember that time when you really wanted to be in Silence of the Lambs, the musical, but you ended up not doing it because you got scared when you had to sing Hello Clarice in front of Miss Turner.
Yeah, well, I really, really want to do this. My mom has been acting extra weird lately. Like the other day, she said that if someone served me a salad with worms in it, I'd have to eat it because it shows good manners.
Well, my therapist says that mother-daughter relationships are really important for growth.
Yeah, well, I read that the first step to becoming an adult is to take control of your life.
Well, I don't know. You aren't really an adult yet.
I mean, she keeps asking me to hang out. I don't know why.
I'm pretty sure my mom has never asked me to hang out.
Lucky you. Hanging out with my mom is the worst. Even though it's just been the two of us for a while now, it still feels like we've never had a connection. I mean, she keeps trying and trying and trying to have us form a special bond. But whatever chance I give her, she just ruins it. And I've been trying to make it work. Believe me, I've been trying. But she just... I don't know. She's still my mom, and I still love her, but she makes it really hard to be a good daughter. Hold on, I need to go.
Thank you.
我一直想知道当个人是个什么感觉，总是破坏大家的家园，甚至是他们自己的家园。如果他们消失了，地球的伤口将会逐渐愈合。既然如此，他们存在的意义是什么？人类是自私的，他们的各种行为并不是为了求生存。与其他生物相比，他们有更强的自我意识和欲望，驱使着他们进行破坏。在他们能力所及的范围内，他们的破坏行为就不会停止。古罗马人是这样称呼我们的 Vulpes， 其含义为一种靠着投机取巧来戏弄他人的生物。然而实际上我们更像是盗贼，不停地盗取，却不知目的为何。这么些年，我一直在脑海里临摹着人的意识形态，而现在我似乎掌握了它的形状。我得出了一个结论，要想了解人类，就必须成为他们的一份子。身为一个人类，饥饿的感觉令人最为痛苦。我在做什么？我不能这么做。我知道身为一个动物，这是合理的，但身为一个人类，这是绝对不被允许的。但这就是人类啊，只要他们可以，他们就不会停止。人类是脆弱的，人类是危险的，人类是机智的。不，尽管身为一个人类，我仍旧无法摆脱动物的本能，甚至不去试着尝试。我甚至无法确定我是不是正确的，我是不是该回去呢？人类难道是这么孤独的吗？我现在真的不知道这到底是善意亦或是同情。或许给一个物品添加价值而不利己，这就是人类的本能行为吧。但他们这种行为却是毫无意义的。我个人的存在并不会为这个世界带来任何更好的结果。 所以我为何身在此处呢？或许我从来不曾来过。如果我没留下任何足迹，那将不会有人记得我。如果没人记得我，那我究竟是否曾经存在呢？
This procedure has many risks. Are you sure you want to proceed?
Hey. Yo, miss. Why the sad face? You're looking lonely. I'll do wonders for you in your room.
Thank you.
Isla, I heard from your mother. I hope you're not driving at this time of night. However, I'm disappointed. I can't believe my one and only niece did that. How do you think this makes our family look,
state before, and it's been a really long night, and I'm calling from the motel room phone. Can't you track me and send someone here? Please?
Judging from the number you're calling from, ma'am, it's not uncommon for some crazies to come knocking. That kind of area. I advise that you just keep your door locked and do not leave until daylight.
What? You won't send someone here?
Unfortunately, don't have any available units, ma'am.
Someone left a bloody baby doll outside of my door. That's a threat. Right?
Now, why would somebody do that?
Sorry, Anna.
godly decision.
Decision.
You know, I've been... Everyone leave me alone!
Godly decision.
Now, why would somebody do that?
One moment.
Que remonte le crash. Je suis fatiguée. Je suis trouée. Je veux plus. Je veux plus continuer.
Hé, hey, relève-toi. Isar, relève-toi.
On tourne en rond.
Non. On va trouver un abri, ok? Relève-toi. Ça fait des jours qu'on marche, on va forcément finir par en croiser un. Allez, fais un effort, relève-toi. Isar, fais quelque chose.
Quand bien même on n'en trouve rien. Un abri est un abri, pas une fusée.
Guarda cosa ho trovato.
È il gioco che ci ha fatto conoscere.
Esattamente un anno fa.
Piacere, però.
Io sono Luna.
Ti va se facciamo una partita assieme? Sta animando tutto.
Dobbiamo smettere prima che succeda qualcosa di grave.
Ma Luna, possiamo usarlo per far apparire tutto quello che vogliamo.
Cosa fai?
Cos'è successo?
Sembravi morta.
Continuare a giocare.
Sì.
Che facciamo?
Scrivere niente così i soldi rimangono.
Oh, non che stai facendo? Non scrivere niente così. Ferma! Ferma!
Please.
Locale per conoscere altre ragazze. Chi è?
Nessuno.
No, aspetta, ti posso spiegare. Quando ci siamo conosciuti, Miranda ha provato ad ingannarmi.
Non ci credo.
Luna.
Ha avuto una settimana per scegliere tra me e te. Indovina chi ha scelto. Perché non me l'avete detto?
Miranda mi minacciava, era ossessionata, continuava a mandarmi messaggi e io te lo volevo dire, ma avevo paura di lei.
Me lo potevi dire, l'avrei fermata. Non ti voglio perdere.
Ti amo. Scusami. Scusami. Hai vinto, amore.
La maledizione è finita.
Yes, I've walked up that track that leads to a road that's headed nowhere. I took a deep breath and decided not to care. Following her call when you're pointing the finger at somebody else. Do you ever stop to think of looking at yourself? on a farm as I reached up my hand and stretched out my arm to touch the water that flowed from your stream, only to find it was not what it
seemed. Stehe vor dem Spiegel und mal mir ein Gesicht. Schicht für Schicht, bis keine Sommersprosse mehr durchschimmert. Ich stehe auf der Tanzfläche. Es läuft Who's That Chick von David Guetta. Aber man geht ja auch nicht für die Musik in den Club. Eine Freundin reibt ihren Körper an dem Körper eines Jungen. Ich beobachte sie. Ich mag sein Lächeln. Er löst sich von ihr und bietet an, uns nach Hause zu fahren. Mama gibt mir immer 30 Euro für ein Taxi. Sie hatte Angst, mir könnte was passieren. Wir steigen bei ihm ein. Meine Freundin flüstert mir ins Ohr, dass sie nicht allein mit ihm sein will. Von dir wird er nichts wollen, sagt sie. Wir lassen sie zuerst raus. Ich bedanke mich und steige aus. Er auch. Er drückt mich gegen die Mauer unseres Vorgartens. Er presst seine Lippen auf meine, als würde er etwas aus mir heraussaugen. Mein erster Kuss. Er schmeckt nach Wodka Red Bull. Ich weiß, dass du das willst, flüstert er. Mein Körper will aber nicht. Mir wird oft gesagt, was für ein liebes und höfliches Mädchen ich bin. Warum kann ich mich nicht wehren? Ich bin kalt. Seine Hände umklammern meine Brüste. Brustwarzen sind schöner, wenn sie kalt sind. Er schiebt mein Kleid hoch. Meine Unterhose runter. Ich schäme mich für meine weiße Haut. Seine Finger suchen nach etwas zwischen meinen Beinen. Habe ich mich rasiert? Du bist der erste Mann, der mich nackt sieht. Findest du mich schön? Wie ein flüchtiger Dieb bist du in mein Zuhause eingedrungen. Hast dich bedient, ohne zu fragen. Alles fühlt sich fremd an. Noch in dieser Nacht fange ich an, meinen Körper zu verbarrikadieren. Keiner darf mehr rein. Nichts kommt mehr raus. Über Jahre steht es jetzt leer. Kein Wasser, kein Strom, keine Leidenschaft. Die Zimmer bleiben unbewohnt. Meine Haut unberührt. Zeit vergeht. Und ich merke, dass Zeit keine Wunden heilt. Ich muss es selber tun. Ich werde anfangen, mein Zuhause neu zu dekorieren. Und gut zu mir selbst zu sein. Ich bin mir sicher, irgendwann werde ich bereit sein, jemanden in mein Zuhause einzuladen.
Okay, so that closes our festival. Thank you so, so much to join us virtually at the International Short Section of the Femme Fatale Film Festival. It is such a treat to be able to share these films with audiences around the world. And feel free to pop a little message in the comment section about where you're streaming from. We'd love to know where our community has expanded to. Don't forget to vote to your favorite film on the Best Show Award at the link video description, and the link is also in a pinned comment. The winner will be offered an interview on the Femme Fatale podcast. And also, don't forget to listen to previous episodes of the Femme Fatale podcast on Spotify, Apple Music, or wherever you get your podcast from. Also, if you're in the position to donate to the festival, you can do so through GoFundMe. The link is pinned in the description of this video and can also be found on a pinned comment. Any little bit makes a huge difference for us, and we really, really, really appreciate it. Oh, and also, if you want to take this with you everywhere, we made some merch this year. If you are interested in buying some merchandise, we're able to ship it, but unfortunately, we do require the buyer to pay the shipping fees. At our current capacity, we're unable to cover these costs. So please, please, please DM us on Instagram at Femme Fatale Film Festival to inquire about our merch. Please, 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 please follow us on Instagram at Femme Fatale Film Festival to stay connected. We always love to hear from you. So thank you again for joining us and stay tuned for the next events. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the screening, and every film was amazing, wonderful. I hope to see you next year. Ciao. Bye.